friends, welcome to the video on circles. Today, we will discuss the concept of the angle subtended by an arc of a circle. Friends, draw a circle with center as O. Take two points, P and Q on it. The part which falls between these two points is called an arc. The longer area between the points is called the major arc and the smaller part is called minor arc. To indicate the major arc, in between the two points we have taken another point named X. If we connect both the points P and Q at the center, then from minor arc PQ, angle POQ is subtended at the center. And from major arc PXQ, a reflex angle named POQ is subtended at the center. If we take point N on the remaining portion of the circle, now connect the point P and Q to the point N. In this way, we will get the angle subtended by the minor arc PQ at point N, that is angle PNQ. Friends, will there be a relation between angle POQ and angle PNQ? There is a theorem related to this question, which says the angle subtended by an arc at the center is twice the angle subtended by it at any point on the remaining part of the circle. That is, according to this theorem, we can say that the angle POQ will be twice the angle PNQ. Friends, let's prove this theorem. Draw an arc AB on a circle. Here, the angle AOB is the angle subtended at the center O by the arc AB. According to the theorem, three cases can occur here. AB can be a minor arc, it can be a major arc, and it can also be a semicircle. Take a point C on the remaining part of the circle. Now connect both point A and B to the point C. We get the angle subtended by arc AB at point C. Now let's connect point C and center O and extend it to point D. Friends, observe that in the first case we got two triangles, triangle AOC and triangle BOC. In triangle AOC, OC and OA are equal as they are the radii of the circle. The angles OAC and angle OCA will be equal because angles opposite to equal side of a triangle are equal. Friends, angle AOD is the exterior angle of triangle AOC. That's why we can write the angle AOD as equal to the sum of these two angles. We can write the angle OAC as AOD. We get angle OCA as equal to the twice of angle OCA. Friends, if we repeat the same procedure for triangle BOC, we will get an equation where angle BOD will be equal to twice the angle OCB. Do it yourself by pausing the video. Now adding equations 4 and 5. Combining the angles AOD and BOD, we get angle AOB. By combining the angle OCA and the angle OCB, the angle ACB is obtained. You can see that the angle AOB is twice of angle ACB.
Friends, we can repeat this process for the second case as well.
Here, the angle AOB is the reflex angle, and in third condition, the angle AOB is the straight angle.
you will find that the angle AOB is twice the angle ACB. Let's go ahead, observe this figure. What can you say about these angles? Friends, all these angles, angle XBY, angle XQY, angle XRY, are the angles subtended by the same arc XY at different points in the remainder of the circle. So we can write the angle XOY in this way. Thus we found that all these angles will be equal. All these angles are located in the same segment of a circle. Therefore, we can say that the angles of the same segment are equal. If this arc XY is a semicircle, that is, chord XY is the diameter of the circle, then the angle in the remaining part of the circle, that is, this segment, will be formed in this way. And we saw the angle subtended from arc XY to the center, that is angle XOY, is twice the angle subtended to any point in the remaining part of the circle. That is, we can write these angles as such. And the angle XOY is the straight angle, so it will measure 180 degrees. Therefore, the measurement of all these angles will be 90 degrees. Thus, we have found another property of a circle, that the angle of a semicircle is a right angle. Today, we discussed the angle subtended by an arc of a circle and theorems related to it. See you in the next video with some questions based on this concept. Thank you.